Now we will see the preparation of the patient and the environment. First point, explain the procedure to the patient to win his confidence and cooperation. Before every procedure, nurse has to explain the procedure to client to win his confidence and cooperation. Explain the sequence of the procedure and tell him how he can take the inhalation. Second point, make the patient to understand that he has to remain in a bed 1 to 2 hours more after the inhalation. So make patient understand that after the inhalation for few hours he has to be in a bed. Third point, ask the patient to go to the toilet and empty the bladder and bowel if necessary. For a bedridden patient, offer a bedpan or urinal so that he will not be disturbed during the procedure. Emptying the bladder and bowel ensure that the patient will remain on the bed for several hours after the inhalation. Fourth point, place the patient in the Fowler's position with the cardiac table in front. If the movement are restricted, place him in a side lying position or place him in any position which is comfortable to him. Example, sitting with a pillow on. Close the doors and windows and put off the fan to prevent the draft. 6-1, place the sputum cup in a convenient place within the easy reach of the patient. 7-1, provide a face towel to the patient to wipe the sweating from the face during the inhalation. Now we will see the procedure of the steam inhalation. We will see it by the step by step and its rationale. So first one, measure the capacity of the inhaler with the cold water. Measure the capacity when it is filled half to the 2/3 full. So we have to measure the capacity of the inhaler with the cold water and also measure the capacity when the jug is filled with the 2/3 of a water. Rationally, to determine the amount of inhalant. Second point, warm the inhaler by pouring a little hot water into the jug and emptying it. To maintain the temperature of the water constant for a longer period. So in the second step, we have to pour the boiling water halfway into the ceramic pot, then the plug the mouthpiece and soothe your vocal cord. Third step, pour the required amount of inhalant into the inhaler and fill the jug 2/3 with the hot water. The water should remain just below the spout. So we have to pour the required amount of inhalant into the inhaler and fill the jug 2/3 with the hot water. And we have to always remember that the water should remain just below the spout. Rationally, if the inhaler is filled to the brim, there is a possibility of drawing water into the mouth and causing scald. If the inhaler is filled till its brim, so there are the possibility of the drawing water, hot water, and the patient may get the scalds or patient may get burn. If the spout is filled with water, it will not act as an air inlet. The patient will not get a warm air. If the spout is fully filled with the hot water, so it will not act as an air inlet and patient is unable to take a steam or a warm air. Fourth point, place the mouthpiece and close the jug tightly. See that the mouthpiece is in the opposite direction to the spout. Mouthpiece, it is a short length pipe, so we have to place the mouthpiece and close the jug tightly and always make sure that the direction of a mouthpiece is opposite to the spout. Rationally, this arrangement keeps the spout away from the patient when the inhalation is taken in. So the opposite direction of the mouthpiece and the spout, this arrangement keeps the spout away from the patient when the inhalation is taken in, and it also helps to prevent the scalds or burning of the patient. Fifth point, cover the mouthpiece with a gauze piece and plug the spout with a cotton ball. After the fixation and the positioning of the mouthpiece, we have to cover the mouthpiece with a gauze piece and plug the spout with a cotton ball. Rationally, covering the mouthpiece with a gauze piece will prevent the burn of lips. As we have to place the mouthpiece between the lips, so we have to cover the mouthpiece with a gauze piece to prevent the burn of the lip. Cotton ball in the spout will prevent the escape of a steam. We have to plug the cotton ball into the spout just to prevent the escape of a steam. from the spout. Now the next step, cover the jug with a flannel piece or a towel. We have to cover the jug with the towel rationally about it to insulate the jug and to prevent the heat loss. For preventing the heat loss, we have to cover the jug with a flannel piece or a towel. Seventh step, that is, place the inhaler in the basin and take it to the bedside without losing the time. We have to place the jug into the basin and take it to the bedside without taking too much time. Rationally, placing the jug in a basin reduces the chances for burn. When we place the jug in a basin, it helps to prevent the chances for a burn. Step number 8. Place the apparatus conveniently in front of the patient with the spout opposite to the patient. Remove the cotton plug and discard it into the paper bag. Rationally, keeping the spout opposite to the patient reduces the chances of burn. Removing the cotton plug helps to keep up the patency of the spout for the air. Step number 9. Instruct the patient to place the lip on the mouthpiece and breathe in the vapor. After removing the lip from the mouthpiece, breathe out the air. Alternately, he should breathe in the steam through the nostril. So we have to instruct the patient that place the lips on the mouthpiece and take the breath in, and after that remove the lips from the mouthpiece and breathe out the air. We have to instruct them that you have to take air in by placing your lips on the mouthpiece, and after that you have to remove the lips from the mouthpiece and take out the breath. And alternately he should breathe in the steam throughout the nostrils also. So rationally directing the steam through the nostril relieves the congestion of the mucous membrane of the nostril. So when we are advising the client to take a steam through the nostrils also, so it relieves the congestion of the mucous membrane of the nostrils. Step number 10. Cover the patient's head and jug with the bath blanket or the bath towel. So it is the last step. We have to cover the head of the patient and the jug with a bath towel or the bath blanket. So as you can see in the pictures, we have to cover the patient and also the jug. Rationally, to help to collect the steam around the face of the patient, thereby the concentration of the steam will increase. Now we will see aftercare of the patient and the article. First point, continue the treatment for 15 to 20 minutes or as long as the patient get vapors. Remove the inhaler from the patient after the stated time. Wipe off the perspiration from the face. We have to remove the inhaler from the patient after the stated time and wipe off the sweating from the face of the patient. Third point, remove the backrest and the cardiac table. Adjust the position of the patient in the bed and make him comfortable, tidy up the bed. Then after the inhalation procedure, we have to remove the backrest and also the cardiac table, adjust the position, provide the position to the patient as he is comfortable to that position. Then fourth point, instruct him to remain in a bed for 1 to 2 hours to prevent draft. So we have to instruct patient that he has to remain in a bed after the 1 to 2 hours of the procedure. Fifth point, take the article to the utility room, empty the inhaler, clean it with a spirit to remove TR benzoin, then wash it with the warm soapy water, rinse with the clean water. So after the procedure, take all the article to the utility room and empty the inhaler, clean it properly by using the spirit to remove the TR benzoin, and after that clean it with the warm soapy water and rinse in a clean water. After cleaning of inhaler, clean the mouthpiece, remove the gauze covering the mouthpiece and clean the mouthpiece thoroughly. So remove the gauze piece which is covered around the mouthpiece and clean the mouthpiece thoroughly. Boil it to prevent the cross infection. Boil the mouthpiece to prevent the cross infection. All the other articles are cleaned with the warm soapy water and then with the clean water. After cleaning the inhaler, mouthpiece, clean all the other articles with the soap water, warm soapy water, and with a clean water. Dry and replace them in their proper place and wash the hand. After cleaning all the article, dry them and replace them at their proper position and wash the hands.